corner, and it's just a few minutes away from Main Street, USA.
But before the parade arrives, there's someone else we should meet.
That's true.
Our roving reporter, our man down there on Main Street, Regis Philbin. Regis, what's going on down there?
Hi, Bruce. I'm right here on Main Street, USA with the best seat in the house. Hi, everybody, and Merry Christmas to everybody.
Hey, Regis, how'd you get right down there on Main Street?
How did I get here on Main Street? Listen, there's about 25,000 people here, but when you have the right connections, anything is possible. You know what I mean? Joan, one of the best things about being down here is to get to say hello and meet some of the people who have come from all over this country to be a part of our Disney World Parade today. Hi, where are you from?
Chicago.
Chicago? What was the weather like back there when you left?
2 degrees.
What does your son want? What do you want, son?
Right here.
Justin.
Is this your boy?
Uh-huh.
Nice to have you with us, Justin. And where are you from, man?
Ohio.
What's your name?
Alan P. Carr.
Whereabouts in Ohio?
Akron, Ohio.
Terrific. And this guy's got an Epcot center?
Yes, sir.
Terrific. Merry Christmas to you. Hi, what about you?
Morehead City, North Carolina.
And what brought you here today?
Mickey Mouse.
And look at the billboard here for Walt Disney World, huh? Nice to see all of you. Listen, we could talk with these folks all day, and I've been known to do that, but right now, how about a little music and song? Right, gang?
Yeah!
All right!
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Ah, humbug!
What an opening. Wow, that's a definite wow. And as soon as Mickey and his friends make their way to the parade route, we're going to be ready to go.
And you'll be getting a bird's eye view of all the characters you love.
Now, I hear that they are now at Liberty Square, and that means, Bruce, that they're just over the bridge.
All right, and our coverage of the parade is going to be spectacular. Yeah. Now, we've got seven cameras, and that's almost as many as ABC Sports uses to cover football games. And one of our cameras is going to be in a very special place. See, it's attached to the first ever video elf.
Oh, wait. For a minute, I thought you said video elf?
I did. He's on Main Street right now, and you're going to be seeing the Very Merry Christmas Parade, well, like you've never seen it before. That's because you're going to be seeing it from an elf's point of view.
Now, Bruce, you never really did explain what is a video elf. So why don't we let the video elf designer fill us in. Mr. Designer, if you please.
Ah, thank you, Joan. The video elf is the result of years of patient design and research. First, you begin with an average elf. What makes our video elf unique is not only can he see things from an elf's eye view, but through the technology of the video camera, you can too. By applying directly proportional counterweights maintained by the use of spirogenic springs, elf and camera become a single unit. In the past, the only way to get all of this action back to you at home was through a cable. However, this had its own limitations. Our modern video elf is his own self-contained video transmitter, enabling him to be free to go wherever his little feet can take him. And there we have it, the world's first high-tech video elf. Of course, none of this means much to you at home, unless our little friend
gets to work!
And now, back to you, Joan and Bruce.
And there is our video elf right now, and I hope he's all charged up, Bruce, because the parade is just about ready to begin in a few minutes. And let's see the parade. Oh, it's coming. It's winding its way in front of the Cinderella castle toward our cameras. And before it gets here, though, let's kind of... There it is. Look at it rounding the corner there. Oh, this is... You can feel the excitement build up when those kids start to hear the music coming. But right now, let's set the stage and take a peek into the Disney album.
Oh, yeah. You know Disney and Christmas go way back. Now, well, we've got a treat for you right now. Let's go back to 1950 and Walt Disney's very first television special. And guess what day it was?
Christmas
Day. Yeah, and ever since then, the Disney people have added a warm touch to Christmas in many ways. Remember this.
Oh, slave in the magic mirror, come from the farther space.
Disney Christmas Show.
The Mickey Mouse Club presents Christmas in Germany.
I'm Annette, and this year I'm going to be your special Christmas correspondent.
Holiday time at Disneyland.
Santa, is everything ready for our big Christmas parade?
Everything but the weather. Yeah. Personally, I feel right at home in this snow, but it's not so good for a parade.
Well, maybe you got something there. Yeah. Okay, Tinkerbell, turn it off. Now there, how's that, huh?
Much better, Walt.
Oh, boy, that brought back some memories.
Boy, does it ever. I think I feel 10 years younger already.
Well, in just a few minutes, you ought to feel like a child again. Mm-hmm. Because the Christmas magic is, well, it's just about here. Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade is about to begin.
That's right. The knights are on their horses, and Cinderella's in her carriage, and we are ready to go. So don't go away, because we'll be right back.
I punched the...
Oh, Okay, are you ready, America? It is time to take off the ribbon and open the package, so let the parade begin. Every great event has to begin with the trumpets sounding and the banners waving. And there they are, the royal procession to start our parade. They're all decked out in brand new uniforms this year, the very finest satins and gleaming white helmets.
All right, what a show. You know, when a group comes down the street like that, you know something big is close behind.
That's right. For see, they're called the Herald Trumpets. And no, that's not because they were invented by a musician named Harold. It's because since princely times, they've been used to herald the approach of royalty.
Well, how many are there?
Well, there are 10 in all here, but you should just know that there are 80 student musicians in all in the parade that have been brought from all over the country.
Oh, they come from colleges, universities, high schools, throughout the United States.
Really wonderful young musicians. The royal rhythm for the procession, the man playing the timpani.
Oh, those drums. It'd be great around my house, so I can tell my kids would have a ball with those things. Well, those are the drummers that keep the band moving. Now, here's what keeps the drummers moving, because right behind him, there's four Percheron horse-drawn carriages. And these horses are carrying the Knights of the Kingdom. And each one weighs around 18 to 2,400 pounds. It's the horses that is.
I'm glad you clarified that.
Yeah, the Knights
that.
Are slightly less. Well, you know, that's as much as a small car.
Somehow I think they might get a little better mileage, though. Don't you think so, though? They are beautiful. Walt Disney loved horses.
Oh, he always
And
does.
These are beautiful animals.
Yeah, there's over 1,700 pounds of horse right there. You know, these are the type of horses that were originally used by the Knights. They were bred to this size to carry all the weight of the armor. I mean, this is living history.
And did you know that these, a little piece of trivia here, mm-hmm. These horses can pull 2 times their own weight from a dead stop.
Our video elf shot right
there.
Oh,
that's
there.
He's right.
Working.
That's the video. He's hard at work down there on the street. Now, you might look at also the knights on the horses. Look at the fabulous robes and the silks on those knights. But you know that right underneath all that is a layer of steel chain metal. Of course, that's to protect them against any heavy swords if they have to defend their little princess. That looks like a little princess right there. Now, here is something brand new this year, Cinderella's Crystal Castle. And just like a castle should be, it is the largest thing around. This is the largest float in the parade, 17 feet tall. In fact, as it goes down Main Street, it barely fits down under the spirals, just clear the garlands above it by about an inch and a half.
All right, right up there on top. Well, that's
there
Prince Charming, my hero. You know, maybe still looking for the girl to make queen. I don't know.
Look at that. Bowing to his audience.
And also, the fairy godmother is running around on that float. We'll wait for her. Oh, you can see her right there in the middle.
Oh,
right
I think
below
I see.
Prince Charming. You see
that's
her in the
right.
blue outfit with the wand?
Oh, that's right. Well, touch of the magic
yes.
wand will do wonders. Oh. You also see who I see there? I think I see the hand mouses,
uh-huh.
Susie and Perla. And, of course, that means that there they are. And that means that Jacques and Gus Gus should have to be around here somewhere because Cinderella never goes anywhere without them. Do you remember some of those wonderful songs from the movie Cinderella?
Oh, sure. Well, it's, I dream a wish a heart makes, right?
Yeah.
Bibbidi boobity boo.
Bibbidi bobbidi boo.
Bibbidi bobbidi boo. That's what it was. Okay, I'm getting this right. Yeah. It goes back a few years.
Yes, it does.
I can remember trying to use that to make my older sister disappear using that magic word many, many times. You remember it?
Sure. Salagadula, menchikabula, bibbidi bobbidi boo. I mean, I use it every day.
Very good. I'm impressed.
Good.
Now, look at that castle. There's over 200 panes of glass.
Oh, there's a little
I wonder if the fairy godmother does windows.
Oh, I'm sure Prince Charming does
these
days.
Of course, yes.
I mean, chivalry and all,
mm-hmm.
don't you think?
It is the 80s.
Oh, and here come our dancers. And
yes.
They are beautiful.
Oh, they certainly are. All the royal dancers dancing all around the float.
You know, they've got brand new finery on this year, Bruce, and all those new satins and brocades. Each costume in the parade is a one-of-a-kind. They're fitted by the Magic Kingdom tailors. I believe they started working on these costumes back in September, and they had fittings in October, and Yeah. They've just started this parade now, mid-December. Oh, look at that.
Oh, Cinderella is here. There she is in the crystal coach.
That's right, the reigning monarch of the Magic Kingdom, Cinderella. Her castle is right in the center of the kingdom here at Walt Disney World, and she is here to officially start our parade.
You know, that may look like a crystal coach she's riding, and that may look like, you know, six tiny white ponies, but they're not.
Well, I know that. I mean, everybody knows that they're really six mice turned into ponies, and the coach is really a pumpkin. I mean, the fairy godmother did all that, right, Bruce?
Did an absolute wonderful job. I wonder how she is with late model cars.
I don't know, but look at that. She did a beautiful job there for Cinderella.
All right, we're going right from the sublime to the silly, because here comes Casey Jr. chugging into town carrying Dumbo and all his circus friends.
And if you've ever wanted to run away to the circus, you'd better take a look at this one. It might change your mind, but then again, it might convince you to go. Look at those guys.
Yeah, there's clowns out there, monkeys, and even King Lion is going to be on the keyboards. He's coming up, but look at all the animals.
There he is. There's King Lion.
Look at the color in that.
It is beautiful.
All the clowns running around. That's what the parade is all about.
That's what it's all about. Look at those faces.
You know, my little boy.
Here come the clowns.
Here
comes look
the clowns around the corner. You know, my boy got. Oh, look at that. Here we go.
He's trying to clean up everybody's act, right?
He certainly is. There's a unicycle. That's tough to do. I'm impressed. He's a good athlete, clowns. They're very good athletes.
You know, he's trying to keep above all the silliness.
Yeah.
Couldn't pass it up, Bruce.
That's good. I like that. You know, all these clowns, they're not far from home, because the clowns are always going to be wintering down here in Florida, not too far from Disney World, either.
That's right. That's where the circus winters. Aha! If you think your house is like a three-ring circus sometimes, put yourself in the position of this poor gentleman. He has a five-ring circus to contend with here. Looks like he's doing okay, though.
Oh, he is, with all those beautiful circus girls.
He should be, right?
Yes, he should be. Doing wonderfully.
Hey, did you see that babysitter going by there with the little crib? How'd you like to have that?
Oh, there she goes again.
How would you like to have that as your babysitter?
Oh, let me tell you, if I had her as my babysitter, I would remember that one. He's going to come up and clean up our act right there in the tub.
That's right. They're down there along Main Street, USA. You know, this parade route is about a mile and 1.2 miles long. Starts in Frontierland and wends its way right through the castle. There are the firemen. Look at that.
This is the crew that's charged with fighting all the fires here in the Magic Kingdom. And you know what, Joan?
What?
I think we're in big trouble.
Oh, no, we're okay, Bruce, because with them is the star of the whole circus. There's Dumbo. Look at him in his big ears.
Oh, I love it. Look like he's got his hands full with that burning firehouse. Will he show him he can fly? That's the question.
But it's always answered in the affirmative, because just one flop of the ears and he's off and flying. You know, Bruce, you're an Olympic decathlon winner, and you know the value of taking the talent that you're born with and doing the best that you can with it. And really, that's exactly what Dumbo did. Even though he had these big, funny-looking ears, bigger than any of the other elephants, he did the best he could. Of course, he became a star.
That's such a good point, John. You know, you can't change what you are, but you can use what you have to be the best you can be. A gold medal for Dumbo.
That's right. Look at him up there.
Now, here's a real piece of Americana, Joan. The Walt Disney Circus Calliope. All right, it's been used by the Disney people for almost 30 years. As a matter of fact, it played in the grand opening of Disneyland back in 1955. It's almost 80 years old.
You know, circus calliopes like this one were kind of Pied Pipers of their time. You might remember the circuses used to come to town, and they would march from the railroad tracks through the town to the side of the big top. And always at the end of that parade would be the calliope, and hopefully would be bringing people along behind it to buy tickets.
Mm-hmm. Well, this particular calliope was built in London in 1907, and first appeared in the Megavon and Bauer show, and later in the 20s, the Howe's Great London show. It was brought to the U.S. Well, it was in the 40s sometime, and soon after that, Walt Disney bought it.
And it is beautiful. One thing, though, I should point out, it has no springs, so the driver really pays a price for his art. Yeah, pretty bumpy ride.
There are 34 pipes and whistles, which are triggered by a non-standard keyboard composed of only the most often played notes. And you know, an interesting point, this thing is being considered to appear in President Reagan's inaugural parade.
You know, Bruce, I can't help but thinking, all this talk about circuses and clowns. I just couldn't help but thinking of Regis down there in the street. Only kidding, Regis, only kidding. But how are things going?
All right, how you doing? Boy, there's a lot of excitement down here. Hi, how are you? Nice to see you. Welcome to the parade. One of the firemen just stopped by here. In fact, all of the firemen are stopping by here. Hi, how you doing? Having a good time?
Wonderful.
What has been your favorite exhibit so far?
We think the marching wooden soldiers.
Oh, the wooden soldiers, eh? They're yet to come. You've seen this parade before. A lot of people have seen this parade as it is shown here at three times a day. All right, that's it from the street side. And now back to all of you.
Thank you, Regis. We'll check back with you later. But, Bruce, what would you say if I said I want to be like you?
Well, I think I'd say, John, you're a little weird.
No, I wouldn't say that. I would say, no, that's very nice. I take that as a compliment.
You're supposed to think of the Jungle Book. Remember, I Want to Be Like You is one of the songs in it, along with the Bare Necessities. And here is the band of explorers and the crazy inhabitants of the Jungle Book.
Well, we've got Mowgli the Man Club, Colonel Hattie, Baloo the Bear, King Louie. You know, they've marched all the way from the far corners of Adventureland to bring us some jungle rhythm to this parade.
And that's a long way, too. All right, we're going to take a break here now and go to a commercial, and then we'll come back with more from Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade live from Orlando, Florida. We'll be back.
Merry birthday.
To me?
To you.
A very merry birthday.
From me?
For you.
Now blow the candle out, my dear, and make your wish come true.
A very merry birthday to you.
Welcome back to Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade, everyone, live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida. And it is so magical down there on the street. Look what's happening.
Oh, here's someone to set your heart racing. It's Herbie. Herbie, the car with a mind of his own.
They don't build them like that anymore.
Thank goodness, Bruce. Even though he's a little car, Herbie's a great big star all around the world. Did you know that in his first movie, that was Love Bug, it was the second most successful Disney film ever, which means it was right behind Mary Poppins, which would mean it was even more successful than Snow White. Look at those guys. They're such clowns, they're never going to win against Herbie. Let's see what he does.
You know, I race cars, and I think sometimes my race car has a mind of its own.
But I'll bet you he doesn't stick out your tongue, that car.
But I would love to have that feature on my race car. Can you imagine? No! Be able to throw your competition.
He ate him. Up, oh, he threw him back out.
Spit him right back out again. I like Herbie. I like machines. Wonder if he drives along Daytona Beach. What a sight that would seem.
I don't know. Oh, look who's coming. Okay, kids, get out your rotten eggs, because here comes the rottenest egg of all, Prince John from Robin Hood. He's there in the carriage, and I don't know who invited this guy. I mean, I guess Christmas Day is forgive and forget, but gosh, he's mean.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you might remember, while his good brother Richard the Lionhearted is away on the Crusades, remember it was Prince John who was always taxing the poor people of the kingdom until they really had nothing left.
One thing the people have left, hope in the form of Robin Hood, who comes to town bringing his band of merry men.
And their merry women,
oh,
too.
Of course.
I think I just saw Maid Marian run by. And also in the group down there is the not-so-little John and the Sheriff of Nottingham.
Briar Tuck, and well, here's a group of funky monks. Yes, it's the monk band. I've never heard a monastery rock like this one.
Boo!
There he is, hiding inside his...
He should be hiding.
And the monk man rocking out. Hey, that's sort of a Michael Jackson type step right there for a second.
That's right.
Never seen a monk do that before. Well, there they go again, right into it.
Well, this happens to be one of Michael Jackson's favorite places in the world, I think, so that's appropriate.
Yes.
I can see why.
Look at that shot, Cinderella's castle, which is right smack in the middle of the Magic Kingdom.
Such a great place to be for Christmas. Such a great spirit down here. Maybe there's no snow, but we have spirit.
Oh, there are the wenches dancing around. I mean, you have to have wenches when you have a Prince John procession. He's such a rat. I think that Friar Tuck is out there somewhere trying to keep the wenches in line.
Yes.
See him back there? He's coming up there pretty soon.
He'll keep them in line.
Hang
around the wenches. He's not too dumb. He knows what he's doing.
Look at those colorful, beautiful costumes.
Nothing like a wench. All right, now here's a brand new addition to the parade this year. The Bear Family from one of the most popular attractions in the Magic Kingdom, the Country Bear Jamboree. And my kids love this. My wife loves all this stuff. It's a good old down-home picking and a grinning.
I say mainly grinning, Bruce.
Now we got Liverlips in there, Henry, Liverlips McGraw, Big Al. I love Liverlips. Look at him working.
Yeah, they have a special show right now that they're doing for Christmas, too, which is really wonderful.
You know, they're taking a break from their brand new Christmas show that they have here just to be with us today. I think that's very nice of them.
I think so, too. All right, now there's a group of talented twangers. We're going to be hearing from Handpicked. All right, let's listen to Handpicked.
Grab your partner, do-si-do. Country Christmas, here we go.
Country Christmas, what a joy. Homemade pies and handmade toys. Lots of singing for you and me. Dancing close and moving slow. Holding tight and loving so. Fancy garlands on the old pine tree.
My wife down the sideline right now watching this, and she really loves this part.
Along with your two little
Hee-haw
ones,
honey.
Who are so cute.
Yes.
Little Brandon and Brody.
Well, I can't keep my toes from tapping, but you know, there are a lot of great music makers all around Walt Disney World. In fact, we have a group with us right now that's going to show us their stuff in a slightly different atmosphere. The place, well, is Epcot Center, just a few miles away from the Magic Kingdom. And the music, well, it's as hot as the Florida sun. If you've ever been to Epcot Center, you know there's this band that comes running. I mean, running right up behind you. You know how exciting their style of music is. The band that, you know, just can't seem to stay in one place for very long. Epcot Center's Future Corps.
Thank you.
Just have one thing to say. Wow. Good music, great music. They have so many great musicians here at Walt Disney World. Really, you can walk through the Magic Kingdom or Epcot Center just about any time, day or night, and catch a great performance.
Not only are they great performers, but that piece was so well produced and so well put together, so much talent. Well, in just a minute, we're going to be back to the parade. And who's on the way? Don't go away.
Hello again. We are back live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida with Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade. And look at that view. That's from up there at the Goodyear Blimp Enterprise. It's based in Pompano Beach, Florida, piloted by Captain Jim Maloney.
Oh, yeah. What a great shot. Well, thank you. Merry Christmas, Captain Jim. Well, let's go right back down now to Main Street.
That's a good place to
go.
Yes. Oh,
yes. See what's going on. Well, look at that shot.
Look at the garlands that go all the way down Main Street, USA. What do we have coming?
And there they are, Geppetto and everyone from Pinocchio. Now there's Geppetto, the puppet maker. They're trying out his newest marionette, which is, of course, Pinocchio. Now there in his workshop.
Blue Fairy, look at her. The Blue Fairy, of course, changed Pinocchio into a real boy just for a short while, and then if he could prove to be a good one, he could stay a boy forever.
Oh, Pinocchio, what a great show it was. You know, it was released in 1940, and now it's being released again.
Oh. That's right.
There are two foul characters. They've gotten Pinocchio's way. Remember that J. Worthington foul fellow, the fox, and the henchman is Gideon. Now, they're all there dancing on the bridge that leads to the road to ruin.
Uh-huh, and there's Pinocchio.
Oh, they got Pinocchio
following them into trouble.
I think everybody has someone like that in their life who sort of always gets into trouble. All right, now there's trouble spelled S-T-R-O-M-B-O-L-I, Stromboli. Now he is mean. Boy, I remember an old football coach I used to have.
Oh, look at all the puppets that he's keeping locked up, and Pinocchio is about to become one of them. And you know what that means? That means he has to dance, 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 and never stop.
Oh.
You know, Pinocchio was released yesterday all around the country, and it'll be in the theaters for a couple of months, and I sure know I plan to take my Jamie and Lindsay.
I do, too. I can remember seeing it as a young person. I still remember.
Oh, Pinocchio wanted to be a real boy. And speaking of real boys, let's go down to Main Street again, where Regis has some real boys and girls with him right now. Regis?
Yes. Ball down here. Look at these faces. Mickey Mouse. And I love this hat right here. This is Pluto. Look, I got a real boy right over here. This is young Jenna, Brandon Jenna, and this is Linda Jenna.
Thank you very much.
Brandon?
Yeah.
Good. Who's your favorite character so far? If you see, I'll kill you.
Honey, Mommy told you not to talk to strangers. Thank you very much.
I got that. Take it away, Bruce.
That was good. Linda's got it right, huh?
Was that a cute kid? Beautiful mom.
Oh, yeah. Right. Oh, and look who's coming here, Bruce. This is the dog catcher. It's Cruella DeVille and her mean dog catcher friend from 101 Dalmatians.
Oh, yes.
That was released in 1961. And look at those. Poor dogs are going to be right in the back there of that little truck here. We're going to see them in a minute.
Remember when Cruella stole Pongo and all the other puppies? What a horrible woman.
That's right.
Yeah. I wonder what she intended to do with those poor animals.
I don't know, but there she is being her mean old self.
Well, Walt was definitely ahead of his time because you look at this character and it looks like she belongs in a rock, modern rock video.
She doesn't look a little punk, doesn't she?
She looks normal today. I think she's going looking for another, maybe puppy she can get. Oh, she's going back to the truck.
There are the dogs.
Oh, plenty of dogs there.
I wonder if those guys are going to get out of there. Nah, she's got them locked up pretty good, I guess. There she,
she is mean.
Uh-oh, there you go. Every dog has his day. Looks like they're getting the upper paw. Nothing to worry about here.
Dog catcher.
I guess we know who's in charge here. Look at him.
I have a feeling those dogs get away about any time they wanted to.
Oh, isn't this a great day, Bruce?
Oh, it is fun.
I just wish Christmas Day, though, could be a little longer. I mean, 24 hours just doesn't seem like enough, you know what I mean?
Well, what would you say if I told you that the Disney people have succeeded in making Christmas, well, longer than 24 hours? In the world of Disney, Christmas started yesterday and ends tomorrow.
I don't think I quite understand, Bruce.
Well, you will. At Disneyland in Anaheim, California, Christmas morning, well, it's just beginning. And Joe Campanella stopped by to record this special Christmas greeting card to send our way.
Thanks, Bruce. Hi, Joan, and Merry Christmas, everybody. Now, Christmas Day may be well underway there, but it's just started here in Disneyland. And what a day it is going to be. Now, I'm standing right here on our Main Street, USA, in front of Sleeping Beauty Castle. And the Disney Parade will march from your Magic Kingdom right into ours here, clear across the country, in just a little while. Now, everybody here is pretty excited because, well, it's not only Christmas, but just around the corner is the start of Disneyland's 30th anniversary year. Can you believe it's been 30 years since Walt Disney first opened the gates to this land of happiness? And funny thing, ABC was here for that, too, to telecast the opening day festivities on July 17, 1955. You recognize that, gentlemen? He was one of the hosts that day. He's now playing a slightly larger role as President of the United States. It's Ronald Reagan, of course. 30 years later, in 1985, Disneyland will host its 250 millionth visitor. And who's going to be doing the counting, you may wonder? Well, it won't be Ronald Reagan, because it's not a who, it's a what. And here it is, the incredible countdown clock. Talk about your Mickey Mouse watches. They tell me it will tick off a surprise for every 30th, 3,000th, 30,000th, 300,000th, and 3 millionth person that visits. Just look at it. Looks like something you'd expect to find here, doesn't it? Well, I know you want to get back to your Christmas fun, and frankly, so do I. So Merry Christmas to you all from all of us here at Disneyland.
Oh, thank you, Joe. Pretty good trick, you know. Isn't that fun seeing that old footage?
Oh, it is. I'm following in Ronald Reagan's footsteps. I mean, he did the show.
So to speak.
Yeah. I don't think I'll ever get to the point he did. Well, you know, if you think that was a good trick, we've got something for you now. Because we're going to go clear around to the other side of the world now, where Christmas Day, well, it's just about over. Now, here with a Christmas message from Tokyo Disneyland Ambassador Rumi Hagihara and some of her friends.
どうもありがとう、ブルースター。こちらはもう夜なんですが、ここには私の友達、チップとデイリーが来てるんですよ。皆さんのところではこれから素晴らしい一日が始まるんですね。私たちのクリスマスはもう終わってしまいましたが、 今年は本当にクリスマスらしいクリスマスでした。私たちは東京ディズニーランドの魔法を見にいらっしゃった何万人ものゲストの方々と一緒にこの日を楽しむことができました。クリスマスに寄せる願いは世界中どこの国でもどの言葉でも同じですね。そう、幸せとファンタジー。私たちはもうクリスマスの幸せでいっぱいなので、今度は皆さんにお分けしたいと思います。 今テレビをご覧の皆さんに東京ディズニーランドのキャスト一同から心を込めてメリークリスマス。
Oh, thank you, Rumi and friends. I guess happiness needs no translation. And we have plenty of it here. In fact, we have a little for you right now from Main Street. When Regis goes looking for talent, he sometimes gets more than he bargains for.
The wife found one of the top barbershop quartets in the world today. They roam around Walt Disney World all the time, and they are the Dapper Dans. And I'm going to join them today as we do a little Christmas song, right?
That's right, Regis. We point to you, you ring the bell.
You okay? Got it. I'm ready.
Give us a ring there.
Just like that.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny... ever saw it, even say it blows all of the other reindeer. To laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games.
bow wow. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as he shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Hey, that was great, but what about the bells, guys?
That's right, Richard. That was a dirty
trick. Didn't you forget something?
What do you think, guys? Should we give him a chance?
Come on.
Sure.
My mother's watching.
Are you ready?
Ready.
We'll be right back. Right back.
You mean now? Okay, how's that? And Mary Poppins is coming up next, and we'll continue with the parade in just a moment.
Holiday greetings from the whole crew here at KOMO.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back, and Merry Christmas. Now, we're live from right here at Magic World, the Magic Kingdom and Walt Disney World in Florida, where, well, we hear reports that up in North Dakota and the Midwest, it's like 50 below wind chill factor.
Yeah.
Temperature is zero. This telecast is going all the way up into Alaska, where they don't even give the temperatures up there, one of the most northern parts of the United States. And, well, it's 79 and rising right here.
There's
also something else.
When we started.
Yeah, and there's also something magical in the air.
That's right. Let's go back down to Main Street, USA, and find out what it is. Oh, and that's what it is. Mary Poppins has arrived with Bert and the penguins and the crazy pearly band.
Oh, Joan, I remember one word for Mary Poppins. You know what it is?
Go ahead, try.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Not bad.
Hey,
not bad.
That was close.
Oh, everybody remembers Mary Poppins. And while we listen to the music from the pearly band, let's listen to the great music written for the movie by Richard and Robert Sherman.
I think there was a spoonful of sugar. Jim Jimmery, Jim Jimmery, Jim Jimmery, Jim Jimmery. Yeah, I don't want to lose the audience. I better stop singing. Step in Time, Jolly Holiday, I Love a Laugh, my song. Feed the Birds, and of course that song with the very, very long name that I said
a minute ago
that I don't want to even try.
You don't have
again.
To try. Oh, and look what's coming.
All right, go from one classic to another. Here comes the Marching Cars from Alice in Wonderland. Along with them, the Queen of Hearts. Talk about a royal flush.
That's right. Watch that. The Queen is carrying her flamingo that she uses for a croquet club. Remember that?
Yes. You know, try to mark those cards, and they may mark you back.
You bet. What a routine. Let's watch them just for a moment.
Uh-oh. The Queen's coming after us. Look out!
White Rabbit, and you always know what the White Rabbit is going to do, and that's run, 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 because he is late, 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 late for a very important date.
Yes.
And he's the one that got Alice into the big mess. Remember that?
Yes. And there it is. Right up on top there, we have something new this year, a giant mushroom, and there's Alice way up on top. Now, that's where she met the caterpillar, remember? And told her to eat one side of the mushroom to get bigger and the other side to get smaller. I think she better eat the big side.
You know, Bruce, Walt Disney and Alice go way back. You may know that one of Walt Disney's very first successful cartoon series, back when he was living in Kansas City, was about a little girl named Alice. It combined live action and animation and really gave him his start, and that was even before Mickey Mouse.
A little trivia for you. Here it goes, okay? Originally, Disney wanted to do a live-action film about Alice in Wonderland back in 1933. Guess who was going to have star in it?
Harry
Potter. Huh. Okay, well, you were lucky.
Not bad.
How about 1945? You thought about making the movie and announced that...
Ginger Rogers,
you're right.
He's going to star, right?
Yeah, and then he did the Song of the South, and, well, who was he going to put in there?
Luana Patton. Everybody knows that.
Yeah. Well, finally in 1946, because everybody knew who was going to star in it, he decided to do an animated feature. Just kidding. He did it as an animated feature, and it came out in 1951.
And it was certainly worth the wait, Bruce.
Oh, it was.
Look at that. Aren't those beautiful, beautiful costumes? Look at the color. And look at the faces. That's, look at that.
You know what's better, the faces that you see on the sides or all these beautiful colors?
remember from the movie, you can learn a lot of things from the flowers.
Oh, yeah.
You meet a lot of interesting people around Disney World, and we're going to meet one of them right now. He's a brand new member of the Disney family, and he lives over in Future World at Epcot Center. And this gentleman's name is Dreamfinder. He has a wonderful job. He collects all the things that dreams are made out of. And he's collected some things of interest, and let's find out what right now.
Hello there. I'm the Dream Finder, and my little purple friend here is a figment of my imagination.
Figment, for sure.
You know, we've traveled all over the world collecting the stuff dreams are made of.
And you wouldn't believe all the dreams floating around out there during Christmas.
So many of them. You see, we fly through the air in my wonderful dream-catching machine, gathering sunbeams, rainbows, feathers, anything that sparks the imagination. And these last few weeks, we've been collecting the wonderful Christmas wishes our guests here at Epcot Center have been dreaming. And we store these marvelous ideas right here in the dream port.
Can we see them, Dream Finder?
Well, I don't know, Figman.
It is Christmas.
Well, why not? Let's see now. Where did I put those Christmas dreams? I know I left them around here someplace. Figman,
huh?
Look.
Wow! Oh, what about hurry?
Figman, calm down. Dreams are delicate things, especially Christmas dreams. You ready? Let's see what some of our Epcot Center guests wish for Christmas.
I wish for peace in this world.
I wish it would be like this on Christmas Day in Massachusetts.
To win the Illinois lottery.
I wish I had a new job for $250,000 a year.
I wish that I could spend Christmas with my mom.
Mucho amor de mi esposa. Bienestar para mi familia y paz en el mundo.
I wish that people would remember the spirit of Christmas, that of giving, is one that lasts all year long, or should last all year long, not just the 2 or 3 weeks that everybody has the Christmas spirit.
I wish that Shannon and I could have a baby brother, right, Shannon?
I wish that there were more hours in the day.
I wish for everyone to be as happy as I am right now, everyone in the world. Because we're on our honeymoon.
And that goes for me, too.
I wish for Christmas I got a big, giant train.
Oh, my Christmas wish is that all my family could get together and unite just like one, and we all stay that way forever.
I wish I was a millionaire for Christmas.
I wish I could get a new transmission for my car.
I wish for a motorcycle.
Did you ever see the Star Wars movie?
Oh, yeah.
And when Han Solo knocked, do you know Han Solo's gun? That's what I want for Christmas.
I could have my girlfriend from England over here for Christmas with me.
I wish I could get my dad a new car.
Wow, those track motorcycles that they go fast.
I wish for my family to be safe.
I wish for a big transformer.
What about all the other dreams, Dream Finder?
Well, some of them have already come true, Figment, and some we're just saving for our friend Santa till he needs them.
But will they keep?
Well, a dream never spoils, Figment, because every time you dream it, it becomes as new and fresh as the day it was born. So keep dreaming your dreams out there. We'll keep them safe here until they come true. And they will. Bye-bye. Say goodbye, Figment.
Goodbye, Figment.
Oh, and I hope those dreams come true for you out there today, too.
And in just a few minutes, we are going to see the man who made many of them come true all around the world, because Santa Claus is on his way with a big Christmas finale to our parade.
And, Joan, there's someone else on the way, too, isn't there?
That's right. Let's look into the Disney album and see who it could be. We'll be right back.
Why, Mr. Scrooge! Merry Christmas! Oh, won't you come in?
Merry Christmas! I have another bundle for you.
But, sir, it's Christmas Day.
Christmas Day, indeed. Just another excuse for being lazy. And another thing, Cratchit. I've had enough of this half-day off stuff. You leave me no alternative but to give you...
Toys!
The Welcome back, and we're live in the excited kids. The
kids.
Christmas finality is coming down the street.
Kids?
Yes.
I mean kids. What about us parents?
Marching down the street right now is the Wooden Soldier Drill Team.
Bruce, I never say drill around the Wooden Soldier.
Right.
Good point, huh?
These guys are plenty tough. Look how they march in unison. Now, they came to life to rescue Tom Piper and Mary Contrary from the evil Barnaby and Babes of Toyland.
That's right. You know, there are twice as many soldiers this year as last. There are 32 in all, in fact. There's some coming. And they are being seen by a lot of people today, Bruce, because this telecast is really a worldwide event. It's being seen all across the continental U.S., in Alaska, in Hawaii, up in Canada, in fact, way up the North Pole, up by Santa Claus' house, being seen. And then it's being seen on the Armed Forces Network, which means it's being broadcast live to Iceland, Panama, the Philippines, Cuba, Korea, and Germany. And it will also be seen in Japan and Diego Garcia. So this is really being seen all over the world.
Well, welcome to all our service people throughout the world.
Oh, that's for sure.
You know, their feet on the drill team sort of look like my feet felt when I was running the 1,500 meters in the Olympic Games.
Here.
And look, here he is.
Here.
He's made it.
He has made it. Mickey Mouse with Minnie riding in the Victorian coach, using these Christmas parades for many, many years here at Disney World. In fact, Walt Disney rode in this coach in 1963 in the Disneyland Christmas parade. And today it carries, of course, his best friend, the most famous personality in the entire world, I would say, and that's Mickey Mouse.
There's no better personality to be inside that carriage right now. You know, you mentioned Mickey as being the most famous face in the world. Well, he is. And you know, almost every country on Earth, they know him. Like in Italy, he's known as Topolino. In Tokyo, he's called Mickey Cucci.
That's right, Mickey Cucci. Oh, look who's coming here, the toy blocks and the teddy bears. How would you like to have to put those toy blocks away, Mom?
Oh, that's a tough one. You know, they got some teddy bears in there that's sort of a switch. They hug you instead of you hugging the teddy bear. I like that one.
You know, this is something brand new this year, this whole toy factory. All year long, they've been turning out toys and all kinds of things for fun, little good little girls and boys and moms and dads. Oh, teddy bears. Kind of a new twist. That's a teddy bear that can hug you,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, right. That's it. Oh, there's the toy factory, turning out all those great toys. I wonder if they could do me a toy. You know,
what would you like?
Boys and girls and moms and dads, just a little private jet.
A little private jet?
Yeah, maybe they could knock this thing off in the next year, when I come down. Well, you said they do it. It says right here they do it for moms and dads.
Oh, there's the ballerina. Look at the ballerina there. I think that's what my little Jamie wants to be right at this stage. He wants to grow up and be a ballerina.
Dancing
probably
with a teddy
bear. Right now. And look who's coming up next. Snow White right there on the side. You see her?
Oh, there she is.
She's presiding over it all, and that's wonderful. You know, that means that the Seven Dwarfs can't be far behind, right?
Okay. Well,
I'm waiting. Can you do all their names?
I was just trying to think for a second.
You want me to try it?
All right. Yeah.
Doc.
Right.
Happy.
Right.
Grumpy. Sneezy. Sleepy, bashful, and you got the last one? Dopey.
Oh, of course I knew that one.
I'm sorry.
Dopey was on the screen, you know, or as Goofy
was
up there.
I know, you knew them all.
Yeah,
all right, but I'll bet you didn't know some of the names that they almost had and then didn't use. These are great. Names like Scrappy, Cranky, Nifty, Shifty, Flabby, Crabby, Snappy, Strutty, and here's one for you, Biggie Wiggy. Those are all suggestions that were never taken. I think I'm kind of glad they picked the ones that they did, aren't you?
Yeah, really. Shifty, I like Shifty.
You like Shifty?
Reason. Yeah, I like that one out of all of those.
Look at the blue skies, just beyond the garland coming down Main Street, USA. You know, there are 373 performers and characters in this parade, and there come the gingerbread people. There's Raggedy Ann and Andy.
Yeah.
They've been rehearsing, you know, for 4 months on this parade. It's one of the biggest parades in the world.
Raggedy Ann and Andy.
The candy canes are there in the background.
Yes.
If you can catch them there, Bruce.
The original candy striper.
That's right.
The candy cane elf.
So to speak. There he is, the guy that's celebrating his 50th birthday, Donald Duck.
Yes.
now. Actually, this whole candy house is a new addition this year. There he is. He has a lot to cheer about. 50 years and he's just as popular as he was when he was born.
You know, gingerbread people have been around a long time. They started almost back 5,000 years ago. Can you imagine that? I think they don't look a day over 30 or 40 there, do they?
Of course not. They're in a little spice of the occasion here today.
Yes, yes. That's another good one.
There's our live video elf shot again.
Yeah, he's working.
And he has the best seat in the whole house, doesn't he?
Yes. You know, there's icing on the roof and ribbon candy on the sides. You just don't know where to dig in first, do you?
Somehow I don't think it's on my diet.
At least Donald's working off some of the calories up there, working very hard, doing his aerobic dancing routine out in front of the house.
That's right. Well, he's got a ways to come. This parade route, again, is 1.2 miles long. It comes from the rustic wilderness right up here to Main Street, USA, which is where you're seeing them right now. I think we've got three little pigs out there.
Oh, look at them.
Twiddle-dee, twiddle-dum. They're out there. Oh, there's Captain Hook.
I can remember as a little kid going and seeing Captain Hook, and I was so scared. I was a big chicken. I have to admit it now. I was a big chicken when I was down there.
How about Tigger the Tiger?
Yeah, Tigger the Tiger in there. And we got the Christmas trees.
The dancing trees.
You know, when I was little, the trees used to eat all the cookies at night for Christmas. Yeah, they did.
Sure, Bruce. And Frosty is leading the way there. You can always tell Frosty, right? He's got that, corn cob pipe?
Yeah, he's got the corn cob pipe. And, you know, that Christmas tree story never worked about the cookies back then, so I don't know why it should work now.
Now, with all this Christmas color, I think we need a little Christmas music, don't you, Bruce?
Oh, it's about time.
And we have just the thing. Let's look.
And what would Christmas be without the carolers? Yeah, well, we found some of the best you'll ever hear, too. And here to really get us in the Christmas spirit, before we see today's very special guest, just listen.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
The kids jingle belly.
When everyone's telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the there'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago.
It's the most wonderful time
of the year. There'll be much
mistletoeing
and
tinseling
and glowing with love and
joy in your ear. It's the most wonderful, most marvelous, wonderful, most marvelous, joyous, most wonderful time. The most wonderful, wonderful time of the year. Noel!
Hey, just beautiful. Merry Christmas to you. Well, you all know who's coming up next, and there's only one way to usher him in. I'm talking about a castle-sized number for you-know-who. The star of our parade, Santa.
What's happening?
Why are all those bells ringing?
It's the sound of Christmas.
Bah, I don't care about Christmas. I'm going home.
Don't touch my sweat.
Christmas carol, sing a Christmas
children do. And enjoy the beauty.
Joining us for our Christmas celebration.
Oh, hi, Santa Claus.
Hi, Santa. And he most definitely is a special guest of the day here. Well, when we return, we'll have another very special guest with a holiday greetings for all of us. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
Oh, this has been a special day for us all. We've met new Disney friends, the Mickey Mouse, Santa Claus, and the things that bring people from all over the world here to visit.
Oh, Joan, you're right about people coming from all over the world, all kinds of people.
Even the President of the United States has been here. He came to Epcot Center to address hundreds of young students from across America and around the world. And we asked President Reagan to record a Christmas message so that we could bring it to you today. So, ladies and gentlemen, we now bring you the President of the United States.
Happy holidays from the White House. Nancy and I and the whole Reagan family, like families all over America, are relishing the happy season that's once more upon us. We hope and pray that all of you are enjoying the fellowship of loved ones and friends. During this time, I hope you'll take a moment to remember those dedicated men and women defending this country who are separated from their families. They are keeping America secure and free. It's the greatest gift they can give, and they're doing it for each and every one of us. Perhaps you might send a thank you note to one of them to let them know just how grateful you are for their gift. We have so much to be grateful for. Our economy is continuing to expand. Our people are uniting with renewed confidence, and many of the problems we were told couldn't be solved are being solved. So let's all make a New Year's resolution to be grateful for the bounty of freedom and material well-being that we enjoy, and to continue getting personally involved in making America all that we know it can and should be. Nancy and I wish you all the very best year ahead. Thank you, and God bless you.
And thank you, Mr. President, and Merry Christmas to you and your family. And I'd like to take this opportunity to say hi to my little ones, little Jamie and Lindsay, who are home with Grandma Joey. Mommy and Daddy will be home this afternoon. And also Bruce's children.
My family made
here.
It with Linda
little
and all
Brody
the kids.
Here.
Brandon, did you have
and
fun
Brandon.
At the, did you have fun at the parade?
Here we go.
Brody's having a ball.
Time. Brody had a great time. Brody's a little tired now. But listen, it's been a wonderful
it's
day.
Been a...
Live from the Magic Kingdom in Florida. Participating advertisers of Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade have been the Florida Division of Tourism. Florida, when you need it bad, we've got it good. And by Days Inns, with over 300 locations from Florida to California. We're working to be the new standard in American lodging. Air travel arrangements provided by Eastern, the airline with more flights to more of Florida. This winter, fly away to a magic kingdom with Eastern, the official airline of Walt Disney World. From the Walt Disney Productions family to yours, have a very Merry Christmas and a magical New Year.